Holy shit, it's the Crusher.
Why should they call him that, sir?
That's why.
Maximus back with another retro review for 31 horror toys in 31 days. And today we're going to rewind it all the way back to 1979 with The Crusher from Mattel. Now, this was something I was not expecting to find. I found this at my local flea market, the Emporium 31 on the south side of Indianapolis in Greenwood, and it was $2. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're like, why would you pay $2 for this thing? It's got paint on it, it looks old and cruddy, and it is. And really, to me, that's part of the charm. This toy was played with thoroughly by some kid, that was probably just a little bit older than me. If you don't know what this toy is, it's actually in the same vein of Stretch Armstrong, so it was released after Stretch. And I kind of look at it as the monster that Stretch would fight, even though I don't think they were actually interconnected. But this is definitely a toy I think history has forgotten. It is obviously inspired by the creature from the Black Lagoon, which is kind of cool, and also reminds me of the Herculoids. So I think the figure run on this was like from 1979 to about probably 82 or so. I know there are a lot of commercials out there and adverts for 1979 and 1980, but I don't think it really went anywhere. So the concept of Stretch Armstrong was to take the figure and kind of stretch it out. This was the reverse. You crushed him. That's why he was called the Crusher. If you look on the back of the figure here, there's a release valve. So you would turn this valve like this, I guess. And then what you would do is you take this toy and you would crush him down. You can hear the air kind of rushing out. Now this one's got a busted valve, so it's not actually going to work. But you would like crush him, crush all the air out of him, and then you would twist the valve and he would stay into a little ball, and then you would release it like that, and then he would come back into form like this. Unfortunately, as you can see, the valve on this one has been busted, but that's okay. I got him just to put up on the shelf just for the vintage look. Very, very cool. Now, there is no articulation on this figure at all. Kind of take a close look at him here. So there's his face. This is the original paint on the eyes there. Somebody has given him some lipstick, it looks like, and some deodorant. And he got painted by someone. I was trying to get that off, but I'm afraid if I do, I'll take the original paint off. So I'm just going to leave it the way it is. And then he's just got some wear from being used and abused as a kid. And then his belt's got a K on it for Crusher in that nice 70s orange color. Lots of nice detail on the scales everywhere. Very nice. Lots of different scaly detail. Here's a look at the back of the figure. Very Abomination looking as well, which is very cool. There's the valve release right there. And then there's these little tail. It's very lizard-like. Also reminds me maybe of the lizard from Rampage that would come later in the 80s video game. But yeah, definitely very cool, very vintage, and I think this is going to look great up on my vintage shelf. For comparison, Here we have the Crusher next to the Monster Venom Build-A-Figure from Marvel Legends. And as you can see, Crusher is actually a pretty good-sized figure. I mean, you can see the walls on next to my stage here. So this is definitely a pretty good-sized toy. And, you know, I think kids would have had a lot of fun. It's very rough and durable. Even after all these years and it being broken, it's still in one piece. And I think that really says something for the toy. So is the Crusher a toy that you want in your horror monster collection? Well, if you like the old vintage monster toys, this is something I think you would really dig. I got a buddy of mine, Chris, who does portraits of old vintage monster figures. I think this is something that he would probably like and could do a really neat sketch on. Last year for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days, he was kind enough to give me a print of a Dracula figure that he had done. I'll leave a link to that in this video so you can go check it out. But otherwise, this could be a pretty easy pass, especially on the price point for this toy. Now I know I said I only paid $2 for this figure, and well, you know, you're like, eh, it's about worth it. But this figure in really rough shape is going anywhere from about $40 to $75 loose. And if you can find this toy with the packaging in good condition, it can go up to anywhere from like $450 to $480. So regardless of the shape that it is in right here, it's definitely worth more than $2. I could probably easily get $20 to $30 for this thing on eBay, which would, you know, make my $2 back and more. But I'm going to keep it and put it up on my vintage toy shelf. So there he is, the Crusher from Mattel for 31 Horror Toys in 31 Days.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, thumbs it up. If you hate this video, thumbs it down. To watch more Ultra Maximus, click on the links to the right. Don't forget to subscribe and share, like us on Facebook, and look for more videos in the future.